Good afternoon, friends. Let's come back to user interface design. So yesterday we were discussing about menu bar. So today we'll start with status bar. So status bar basically information of use to other user can be displayed in a designated screen area or areas. So these status bars can be located at top of the screen in some platforms and called a status area. Microsoft recommends the bottom location and refers to this area as a status bar. For example, this bar, what we are, I'll show you. Yeah, this what I'm showing you, this 13 items, one item selected, 5.61 GB, this is a status bar. So, for example, if you open Microsoft Word, and I think that represents a status bar very well. I'll just try to open a Word document and show you what is the meaning of a status bar. Look here. So it is showing you page one of totally 450 words, then what language you are using. So this is basically a status bar. I hope you people are understanding me. Basically it shows the status of the page, what you are viewing, whether it is connected or disconnected, offline, online, something like that. Windows suggests using the status bar to display information about the current state of what is being viewed in the window. Then next one is scroll bars. Scroll bars are, if the information is too large, if it is not fitting in a single page, then generally we scroll. For example, what I am doing now is scrolling so that you can go to the next page. Otherwise, you can use the arrow buttons. However, it takes a lot of time. Or else you can use page up or page down to scroll between. You can see this is what is called as a scrolling. So this is scroll button, similar like what we are using. Again, I think we have to use scroll. When all display information cannot be presented in a window, the additional information must be found and made visible. This is accomplished by scrolling the displays contents through use of a scroll bar. So what you are seeing here, this is basically a scroll bar. Then the next one is split box. A window can be split into two or more pieces or panes by manipulating a split box located above a vertical scroll bar or to the left of a horizontal scroll bar. Earlier these features were incorporated, but however, now these days you don't find this option in most of the applications, because generally the users get confused. Even though it has got many advantages, for example, you can split this document into two, so that parallelly you can read the contents of a same document. A split box is sometimes referred to as a split bar. A window can be split into two or more separate viewing areas. For example, I think show windows stacked. So you can see you can see different windows. So this is one kind of splitting the window and making giving it a space. Providing a space for many applications or many windows. So some advantages are: examine two parts of a document at the same time, or display different at simultaneous views of the same information. So the next one is toolbar. Toolbars illustrated in figure 5.3. This is figure 5. So this left side is basically a toolbar. So you can find so many tools here. There is a eraser, there is a scissor, there is a pen, there is a color chooser, palette. I will show you. You can call it as a toolbar. So multiple tools are available here. You can just use any one of them. Toolbars illustrated in figure are permanently displayed panels or arrays of choices or commands that must be accessed quickly. So the advantage of toolbar is you can access the things very, very quickly. You don't have to go click here and go to that particular menu, then again click here. Instead of that, if the toolbar is available here, you can go wherever you wish, or you can do whatever you wish. Specialized toolbars are sometimes referred to as ribbons or toolboxes, rulers or palettes. I hope you are getting these things. These are very, very simple things so that you can easily understand. Then command area. Command area, especially if you use MATLAB or Python or these kind of applications, apart from the normal editor where you type your program, then beneath that or below that area, they provide some special area where you can execute the commands. You can type the commands and execute. So this area is called as command area. In situations where it is useful for a command to be typed into a screen, a command area can be provided. So this is a special area where instead of using any UI, for example, if you are executing a C program in one of the IDE, then you have to go click something, then first you have to compile, then you have to execute it. Instead of that, you can just type the command, then automatically it will be done. So that is this area where you can execute your commands is called as a command area. Next one is size grip. A size grip is a Microsoft Windows special handle included in a window to permit it to be resized. When the grip is dragged, the window resizes. For example, look here. I think I will unstack. Undo, show all windows stacked. Now, So for example, if I want to resize it, so there are many options by which you can resize. For example, look here, I can. So this is called as a size grip, so you can use it. A size grip is a Microsoft Windows special handle included in a window to permit it to be resized. When the grip is dragged, the window resizes. Then basically what I shown is not a size grip. This is again different. However, it is a form of a size grip. Then work area. The work area is a portion of the screen where the user performs tasks. It is an open area inside the Windows border and contains the relevant peripheral screen components such as a menu bar, scroll bars, messages bar. For example, in Adobe, now this is a from here till here, from here till here, this is a work area where user can read the information, or you can edit the information, you can highlight the information. So this is basically a work area. Then Windows, we will start discussing about window presentation styles. I think we will continue in the next video. Thank you.